Hey everyone, in my last video, I showed you how to animate a like button and do it on the master slide so it shows up on every single page. Now in this video, I want to talk about actually how to send over an xAPI statement that would then track what pages are being liked and what pages are not. What the data gives you is what is working inside of your course. What are people really connecting to inside of your course? So that is that like button down at the bottom. So I have this on my master slide. So as I go throughout all the different pages, you can see how that works. Now on the master slide, I also in previous videos talked about, and I'll link those videos at the end, I talked about how to do the animation like that, but I also talked about how to make sure that it shows up on top, even though it's on a master slide, shows up on top of anything, any content that you may have on your page. So those are important steps to really make this work as well. So make sure you check those videos out. Now let's go into this real quick. And I'm going to go into the master slide here, and I'm going to go up to the master slide here. Now, what I'm going to do is go back to the master slide down at the bottom, and I'm going to add a trigger. Now, the trigger is going to execute an xAPI statement. So let's go ahead and add that trigger right now. On that trigger, we can do send an xAPI statement. Unfortunately, there is not a liked verb inside of here. I've talked about also in previous videos how you can replace this, and that's what we're going to do. So I'm just gonna stick with experienced for now, and I'm gonna go ahead and just grab the page for this. And so you can see under slides, I'm just gonna get the current page. Now, because it's a master slide, the current page will still get tracked and it will automatically get updated without you having to do anything because it just adopts whatever the page name is from the master slide. So that's one of the benefits is I just have to grab this current page and it will take care of the rest from there on. All right, so now I'm gonna do this when the learner clicks on the button. So make sure that we change the when part to when the user clicks and it's gonna be on controls one. So not object intersects, but object when the user clicks, there we go. So now it's going to send over the xAPI statement. It's still going to animate, do everything else that we need it to do, but it's then going to send over the statement. Okay, so what we need to do after we add that xAPI statement, I'm gonna actually pull this back up. We forgot to change out the verb and the object here. So to do that, I need to come into the xAPI. So all you do is click on this plus xAPI. We need to switch out this, keep the quotes, and we need to switch out this. To find out the different verbs, you can go to the xAPI concepts viewer. I will add a link in the description here. And this is from Torrance Learning, and it's basically a list of all the different verbs that you can use and activity types and other things like that. So I'm going to select this drop-down box, and I'm going to go down to verb. Now inside of here, I'm going to type in liked. And so you can see right here, there are two likes, and you can use either one of them. I'm going to go to this one right here, and I'm going to copy this line of code right there, that URL basically, and I'm going to paste it right there. And there we go. Then we have the like right there. Actually, no, this one, I want to have liked instead of like. So I'm going to do this one up here. So I'm going to go back into there. And there we go. That's what I want. I want to have the liked as part of that verb. Then I'm going to copy this one right here and then come in and just paste that right there. So now we have the verb that we'll send over. So I'm going to go ahead and click OK. And then from here, in order to test this out, I will need to publish this out. And you can publish it out as CMI5 or xAPI. You can do this to an external learning record store, or you can do this into your own learning record store. I have already published a version of this out to SCORMCloud. SCORMCloud allows you to test xAPI statements. It allows you to test SCORM packages. I do this as kind of my initial testing, and then I publish it out and then make sure that it's working here before I get it into any real learning record store or anything like that. So you can see here, this course is a little bit different, but I did the exact same triggers here. And I'm going to click on launch here, and I'm going to click launch here. So now what will happen is as you go throughout the course, you can click the like button and it will send over the statement. I'm going to go ahead and exit that out just so we can see what that statement looks like. So if I go to view registration statement history, you'll notice this liked. So Jeff Batt liked full half. That was the name of the page. And there is the verb itself. There's the ID. There's the verb, the liked. And then here's the page name down at the bottom. Now that we know that it's working, I can then create, if you're sending this over to your own learning record store, the power of a learning record store is you can create custom reports based on this information. So I have Veracity pulled up and I've already hooked to this page. And in fact, I created a report that is pulling in the liked verbs. And then based on the liked verbs, it is pulling in the name of those pages. So the data that it gives me is basically showing me that these are the most liked pages of your course, the ones that people are finding the most useful, the ones that people are taking the time to actually click the like button. That lets you know what is working and basically immediate feedback on that page if somebody really liked it, if somebody found it useful, something like that. And you can add different buttons and different controls, but you could be sending over these statements. Now, I want to dive into this report because when you come into the dashboards here, you can create custom reports and then you can add widgets here. That's what I did already. And I'm going to go into these widgets and you can see that it's a bar chart. And basically, I'm going down to the object, definition, and name. So that's the first thing I'm doing. If I come back into here under this JSON, basically there's the object, there's the definition, and there's the name. So you just look through the JSON to target those pages. I want to create a row for each of the page names, and that's what I'm doing there. So if I come back into here, you can see that it is going to take the total count for each of those. So right here, three people clicked on the like button for introduction. So that is the first thing, but then I want to filter it out based on the verb. So you can start to add filter layers. And in this case, I'm adding a filter for verb display. So if I go back into my JSON, I'm going to go back up to verb. And I'm going to go into the display and I'm going to grab the English version right there. And that is what I'm going to do. And if it's equal to liked, so I'm basically just saying, give me the liked verbs. That's all I'm doing. The next line is basically the ID, the course ID. Whenever you publish out a course and you click on reporting and tracking here, you establish the course ID right there. So that this one is a little bit different than the one you're seeing, but that's where that ID is coming from. And that's why it's important to add your own ID. That way you can filter it out by course instead of several courses, because it will go through liked on anybody that has been sent over to this learning record store. So that is how easy it is to set up a liked button inside of your course. And that way you get information on the page level of what people are doing, what people are liking as well. And that just scratches the surface of xAPI and what you can do. If you want to check out more, you can head on over to my website at learningdojo.ninja. You can check out all previous blog posts. I have several on xAPI. You can also download templates and Articulate Storyline and also xAPI templates. Or if you're new to this, you can also check out full courses in Articulate Storyline 360, Adobe Captivate, xAPI Fundamentals, where I cover everything from A to Z, Camtasia, Articulate Rise, Custom SCORM, and HTML5 Video. If you like this video, head on over to my YouTube channel, click the like button, and subscribe to my channel, as well as hit the bell notification so you get notified of all future videos as they come out. That really helps my channel, allows me to continue to grow, and allows me to continue to produce these videos for you to help you become the best learning developer that you can be, to really expand your skills and push the limits of these authoring tools. If you also have any type of suggestion, feel free to comment down below and let me know what else you want to see or what else you're trying to work on as well. Again, that's all I have for today. So thanks everyone, and I'll see you next time.